God for his goodness and mercy. You may be seated in the presence of God. I request God for this year. We thank God for this year. Happy New Year for those who have not met. Those we have not met for many days. Welcome to our first service. This is our first service. And we thank God for the fire he brought us. We have seen the hand of God in every aspect of our lives. We have seen God protect us, favor us. And this far, we say it is God. Bwana asifiwe. So I want to concentrate with the word of the here now, because we are in the new year. I want us to concentrate into the word of the year. We are saying that 2021 is a year of mounting up with the wings like eagles. We are saying that 2021 is a year of mounting up with wings like what? Eagles. So this year, after many challenges, God is taking us to the next level. Last year, we were saying it was the year of restoration, and our focus was Joel 2:25. This year, the word of the year is Isaiah 40:31. That will be our focus. I want us to look at a few things about Isaiah before we come to the word. I want us to look at a few things about Isaiah so that we can come to the word. The name Isaiah means the Lord is salvation. So we need to get that. For those who have read the book of Isaiah, it has many themes. It has the themes for captivity and the restoration and in God's salvation. Many themes are there. So we need to know that the name Isaiah. Isaiah means God is salvation. So if you look at the writings of Isaiah, mostly they acknowledge God's sovereignty over his people. God's sovereignty over his people. They reflect God's sovereignty over his people. As well, another thing about Isaiah, it reminds us that we can be holy in the presence of God. It reminds us of our mandate as the people of God. So it tells us we need to be holy. We need to be holy because the one who has called us is holy. Another thing about Isaiah, it gives us a glimpse of God's amazing plan to reclaim his people through arrival of a deliverer. So it gives us a glimpse of the coming of Jesus, the amazing plan of God to reclaim his people through the deliverer, through and deliverer, Jesus Christ. So Isaiah talks, it's about deliverance, salvation, one as if you were restoration. It's about God's power. All those things, if you read the book of Isaiah, you will get those reflections. Now we have chapter 40, of which I don't want to be ignorant of. The Isaiah chapter 30, if you begin with chapter 39, chapter 39 talks about judgment. If you read Isaiah chapter 39, it states about what will happen to the children of Israel because of ignoring his word. So it begins, chapter 39 talks about judgment, about the Babylonian captivity. But chapter 40 begins with hope. That's why if you look at Jeremiah, let's go to Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 40 verses 1 begins this way. Comfort, yes, comfort people, says your God. Comfort, yes, comfort. So the first word, the way it is stated, it's like a question. People are not sure if God was talking about comfort. But the one says, comfort, yes, comfort my people, says your God. So, Isaiah chapter 40, after judgment, after God reclaiming what will happen to the children of Israel, After God talking about their captivity, that they will be taken by the Babylonians, he begins chapter 40 with a word of hope. Wanasifiwe. So we know what we have gone through in 2020. We have gone through many things. But we are here to tell you that there is hope. Wanasifiwe. There is hope. We need to look, we need to focus on a better here. One thing I want to tell each one of us, you need to see, whatever you see, that's what you get. Whatever you see, that's what you get. We have seen people give testimonies of what God has done in their lives. Well, others began crying even before Corona came. So it depends with your attitude. Because one thing, when we lose hope, then we see everything going down. You start seeing everything going down. I want to declare to somebody, we should not focus on what we are going through. We need to focus on what God is doing in our lives. One as if you were. So year 2021, we are still in the morning of 2021. And you can change your perspective toward this year. You can change your perspective. You can change your perspective. So God begins with a word of hope. Comfort, comfort. After many challenges, here comes comfort. After many trials, here comes comfort. So we have comfort. We need to look for a better year. We need to see 2021 as a year of better things. So God begins verses 1 with comfort, comfort. Yes, comfort my people. Says you are gone. Speak comfort to Jerusalem and cry out to her that our warfare is ended. That our warfare is ended. I want to declare to somebody. I want to speak to Kenya today. I want us to speak to Kenya. I want us to speak to our families. I want to speak us to speak comfort to our children. Speak comfort to everything God has given to us. We need to speak comfort to ourselves. So God tells King Prophet Isaiah, speak comfort to Jerusalem. Speak comfort to the people of Kenya. Speak comfort to the people of the world. And cry out to her that our warfare is ended. I've come to tell somebody, your warfare has ended in Jesus' name. Your trials, your challenges have ended. So we need to pick this year with those ones that our battles are over. God has taken us through. Our challenges are over in the name of Jesus. So we need to focus on that because whatever you see is what you get. You cannot receive more than your attitude. Your attitude determines your height above the sea level. If you see yourself going down, then that's what you get. So we need to see the comfort God is speaking of. Our wars are over. Our battle with COVID-19 is over. Our battle with business, our battle with the economy going down is over. God is doing something in our lives. God is doing something in our city. God is doing something in our nation. God is doing something. Our political confusion is over in the name of Jesus. God is bringing sanity in our nation. God is bringing sanity in the church in the name of Jesus. So we need to see comfort. Let's celebrate God for his goodness and mercy. So the Bible says that our warfare is ended, that their iniquity is pardoned. I want you to raise your hand, declare, O Lord Almighty, thank you for pardoning my iniquity. Thank you for pardoning my iniquity. So, what made God to punish you, he has forgiven. Our God is a forgiving God. So, I want to assure you, you are forgiven. Whatever caused us to go through what we went through in 2020, God has pardoned us. We are forgiven. One as if you were. I want you to shout, I am forgiven. I am pardoned. You have been forgiven. So you don't need to live in guilty. Because another problem is when we live in guilty conscience, when we think we have sinned, when always whatever comes our way, we connect it with what we have gone through. Whatever happens in our families, we start connecting with the things which have happened. I am here, as the word of God says, to declare to you that you have been pardoned. So there is no punishment in 2021 because God has pardoned us. He has pardoned whatever we did as a nation. God has pardoned us. Whatever we did as individuals, whatever we did in our city, our God has pardoned us. We are free. We are free to soar with wings like eagles in Jesus' name. Let's celebrate God for his goodness and mercy. The Bible says, for she has received from the loins and double for all our sins. What does it feel? We have received double for our sins in 2020. Many people have gone through challenges, but in 2021, God has pardoned us. What does it feel? As our iniquity has been pardoned. Verses 3. The voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be exalted. So the Bible now, verses 3, predicts about the coming of Jesus. These are the same ones which John the Baptist was preaching in the wilderness. So verses 4 says, every valley shall be exalted. So this year, God will be in our midst, and every valley shall be exalted. It shall be covered. May the Lord cover valleys in your life in Jesus' name. Every valley in your business, every valley in your family, every valley in your working place, may the Lord cover them in Jesus' name. Then the Bible says, and every mountain and hill brought low. May the Lord bring low every mountain in your life. It can be a mountain concerning your health, a mountain concerning your business, a mountain concerning your family, a mountain concerning your children. May the Lord flatten those valleys in Jesus' name, those hills and mountains in Jesus' name. The crooked places shall be made straight. May the Lord straighten your life. Every crooked part of your life, every crooked health, every crooked family, every crooked marriage, every crooked business, may the Lord straighten in Jesus' name. So that's the year we are in, the year 2021. The Lord shall straighten crooked places. Then the Bible says, and the rough places smooth. May the Lord smoothen your life this year in Jesus' name. Your rough places will be smoothened. The glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken. The glory of the Lord represents the presence of the Lord. When there is the presence of God in your life, you will be provided for. You will be favored. You will be directed. You will be strengthened. You will live in divine health in the name of Jesus. So I want you to raise your hand, declare, O Lord, may the glory of God be upon my life this year in Jesus' name. Let's celebrate God for his goodness and mercy. The glory of God shall be in your family. That means the wrangles you have been going through in your family are over in Jesus' name. The wrangles you have been experiencing in your working place are over in Jesus' name. The glory represents the presence of God. We are praying this year. We are still praying that this year it's our season for signs, wonders, and miracles. So we are praying as a church that the presence of God, the glory of God, shall fall upon this place every time you enter this place in Jesus' name. One as if you were, the presence of God shall be in this house. That means anytime you enter this church, you feel the power of God working in your life. So we are still in the seasons for signs, wonders, and what? Miracles and testimonies. That's what we are saying. So the Bible says, the glory of the Lord shall be revealed. May the Lord reveal his glory in your life in Jesus' name. But the 6 years, we are still in Isaiah 40. The voice said, cry out. And they said, what shall I cry? All flesh is grass, and all its loveliness is like the flower of the field. Then grass withers, the flower fades, because the breath of the Lord blows upon it. Surely the people are grass. Then grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our God stands forever. So today, those who are in the word of God, they shall stand forever. Let me tell you, I like reminding you, whatever you see with your eyes is temporal. But the word of God in you is permanent. It's only the word of God which is permanent. All other things, the things you waste so much energy and time looking for and working for, are temporal. But the word of God which is internal, we rarely spend time in it. So in 2021, I want to challenge you to change your program and focus on the things of God. Change your program. Focus on what is internal. We waste so much on what is temporal and forget the internal. All man is grass. All buildings are grass. One day I remember we talked with a brother here in church, and he told me how a city was burned. It was consumed by volcano. And hiyo kitu ilinisumbua. Because alikuwa ananiambia nyumba ilikuwa inayeyuka. Wale mmeiona ile volcano inaendanga kama mto ya moto. Ikipata nyumba itaki kujua ni mawe ama ni chuma ama ni nini. Si mnajua moto ina it can consume anything. Bwana asifiwe. So ikipita mahali within a few minutes there is no tree, no house, no stone, no anything. Everything is a river of fire. Now I realized how powerful God is. And those who have read science well, you know underneath there is fire. Bwana asifiwe. There is fire. That's why we have volcanoes. It's God who contains them. Imagine if one day God decided to open even a kilometer radius of that. Then the whole state of Nairobi will be no more. So what am I saying? The many things we fight for, the many things we waste time for are temporal. This year we need to decide to concentrate on the internal things, which is the word of God. We need to give ourselves to the things of God in 2021. So 2021 is a year of commitment to the things of God. We need to commit ourselves to the things of God. If you are a worshiper, you need to worship as never before. You need to make a decision. And one of the things as you write your proposals for this year, you need to declare that you will never be late for a Sunday service. Because most of us, we just come to church like a market day. It's like a market day. So you know, you have a market day. You can go one day and miss the other. One as if you. So most of the time, that's how we do our things of God. So we need to make a decision. You need to make a decision that this year you will be in the church. You will not miss prayers. You will not miss Bible study. You will not miss any meeting concerning the things of God. If you have ministry this year, you will use it for the glory and the honor of your name. One as if you were. It's only here where you can use what God has given to you to bless his name. Aba naishi kama wasee wa zamani hata huko mbinguni, tutaimba hosana, tutaimba, tutatembelea barabara za dhahabu. Hapana. If it's worship blessings, claim them here. Because in heaven, I like telling people, heaven belongs to God, earth belongs to man. Bwana asifiwe. Yes, that's why Jesus said there is no marriage, hakuna ndoa mbinguni, hakuna biashara mbinguni, hakuna pesa mbinguni, karenze ya mbinguni. Haujui ni ya mwenyewe, no buying, no selling. So if you want to do any buying and selling, do it here. If you want to marry and be married here. If you want to do anything here, heaven belongs to God. You can control here, but you can't control heaven. What happens in heaven, you cannot. One as if you. So I want us to make a decision this year that I will live for God. I will live for God. I will go for the internal and not the external. I will not go for the permanent things and not the temporal things. So the Bible says, everything will end, but the word of our God stands forever. That's why we say, it shall be permanent. The promises God has given to you are permanent. No demon, no Satan, no evil can revoke what God has promised to you. The word for the here is we will soar with the wings like eagles. That's the word of God, and it must be permanent in Jesus' name. It is permanent. We need to claim it and declare it shall be permanent and it shall work for us in Jesus' name. In verses 9, the Bible says, O Zion, you who bring good tidings, get up into the high mountains, O Jerusalem. You who bring good tidings, lift up your voice with strength. Lift it up. Be not afraid. Say to the cities of Judah, behold your God. Behold, the Lord God shall come with a strong hand, and his arm shall rule for him. Behold, his reward is with us, and his work before him. He will feed his flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs with his arm and carry them in his bosom, and gently lead those who are with young. That's the promise of God in this year. He will lead us. He will guide us. He will provide for our needs. One as if he were. He will bandage our bruises. He will heal us. Whatever. So that's the promise in this year. But we should not keep quiet. Another thing we are getting. We should not keep quiet this year. One as if you were. You need to be known in that office that you know Jesus as your personal savior. Are you ready for that? We need to speak out. One as if you were. You know, sometimes Christians, we are too quiet. We are never noticed in our offices. We are quiet. Sometimes we are shy. We don't want to identify with God. In your office, you are very quiet. You don't seem as if you are saying, we need to stand. One as if you were. So we need to speak out this year. We need to go to the mountains and speak out. And speak out. One thing I want us to realize, anytime you confess a word, it works for you. Confession of faith is very important. What you speak, what you are proud of, will come to pass. One as if you were. So this year, we need to be proud of our God. Wherever you are, that's why we are saying we are in the season for testimonies. Because testimony means you will tell people, when you succeed, telling people, it's all about Jesus. It's God who has given to you. You have a new car, you need to testify to your friends that God has provided. Don't just say that I have saved hand. It's my hand work. No! There are people who are working under than you, but they have nothing. One as if you were. So we need to boast of the Lord, because whatever you have, it's about God. So these are here of testifying. These are here of going out and proclaiming the name of Jesus. So this year we need to stand out. I declare to each one of us this year, I want you to declare, O Lord Almighty, in the name of Jesus, 2021 is my year of standing out in Jesus' name. You will stand out wherever you are. In your working place, you will stand out. You will walk chest high. You will not just crawl down. Mounting with wings means You are visible. And you can never be visible in crowds. You are visible when you are up there alone. When you are soaring with wings like an eagle. An eagle is visible. You will always see an eagle. So we will come to that. But I want to declare to you this year, it's not an year of keeping quiet. We need to be known. We need to speak out. We need to go out to the marketplace. We need to go out to the political arena. We should not just keep out quiet here. Remember? So I want to challenge you. We need to speak out in every aspect of our lives. In business, we need to speak out. We need to start taking Katani Road. There are so many businesses in this road. We need to see people. I need to see members doing something in this road. Something is happening in our road. If you are very aware of. Alpa mpaka mwisho, angalia tu, many things are happening. And we need to be partakers of the blessings of this city in Jesus' name. We need to speak out. We need to speak out in every aspect of our lives. We need to speak out in evangelism. We need to speak out in Jesus' name. So the Bible says we need to stand. Verse 12, who has measured the waters in the hollow of his hand and measured heaven with a span and calculated the depths of the earth in a measure, weighed the mountains in scales and the hills in a balance, who has directed the spirit of the Lord or as his counsel has taught him, with whom did he take counsel and who instructed him and taught him in the path of justice, who taught him knowledge and showed him the way of understanding. Behold, the nations are as a drop in a bucket and are counted as the small dust on the scales. Look, he lifts up the isles as a very little thing, and Lebanon is not sufficient to burn, nor its beasts sufficient for a burnt offering. So that speaks about the greatness of God. So this year, the greatness, the majesty of God will be seen in every corner of our lives in Jesus' name. I want you to raise your hand, declare, O Lord Almighty, I declare in 2021, the majesty of God shall manifest in my life in Jesus' name. So unapoomba mwaka huu, you need to tell God that his majesty, his marvelous works will manifest in your life. The greatness of God shall be seen in your life. And don't sijui kama unanipata yako ukuu wa Bwana utaonekana maishani mwako pande zote, in your family. The majesty of God, the greatness of God will be seen in business. Watu watakuwa nasema, we don't know. I love one member tuliombea hapa. Na mahali alikuwa anafanya kazi, wengine wanakuja kumwambia, "Eh, na unaendanga kwa muganga gani wewe?" Naye akawaambia ni Yesu. Bwana asifiwe. Watu wakikuuliza unaendanga kwa muganga gani, usiwakemee, waambie kujeni niwaonyeshe. Waonyeshe msalaba. Bwana asifiwe. You need to identify with the people the way they want. Bwana asifiwe. You know many people in Kenya identify with the witch doctors. Especially in some of, even not some, in offices. Some, most offices, people are identifying greatness with the devil. Unakuanga Freemason gani, unawambia, Jesus. Jesus is my Freemason. Bwana asifiwe. Jesus is my muganga. Kama wanataka hiyo jina. You know Jesus is everything to anything. Bwana asifiwe. Jesus is all in all. He takes over everything. Bwana asifiwe. His power is every. Hata wale wanatumia ile kindogo. I was doing a study this week and I realized that the devil lives in limited power. Ile tu alifukuzwa nao mbinguni ndio anarukisha rukisha huko. But we are connected to the source. We are connected to the source of power. God is the source of all powers. God is the source of all powers. That's why when he does not send water, then we have no electricity. Tunawekwa rationing. Kwa sababu amenyimana nini? Mvua tu, rationing ya maji, rationing ya stima. The source of power. So when we connect to God, the devil has nothing. So this year, we need to tell God to manifest. We need to make sure God manifests in every aspect of our lives. And that can happen by us living by his word. Bwana sifiwe. Let's celebrate God for his goodness and mercy. Verse 17, the Bible says, all nations before him are nothing, and they are counted by him less than nothing and worthless. To whom then will you liken God? Or what likeness will you compare to him? The workman mourns an image. The goldsmith overspreads it with gold. And the silversmith cuts silver chains. Whoever is too impoverized for such a contribution chooses a tree that will not rot. He seeks for himself a skillful man to prepare a carved image that will not totter. Have you not known? Have you not heard? Has it not been told to you from the beginning? Have you not understood from the foundations of the earth? It is who sits above the circle of the earth, and its inhabitants are like grasshoppers, who stresses out the heavens like curtain and spreads them out like a tent to dwell in. So the majesty of God, the power of God. So this year, we are telling the idol worshippers that all idols are the works of men. One as if you are the works. Let me tell you, how can you make something and then go back a few steps and kneel on something you have made and call for power from it? Who has power? The maker or the image? One as if you are. So those who worship idols, I don't know the name I can give to them, because an idol, it's man-made. And then you want what you have made to make you. That can never happen. So we need to know that all idols are the works of men. But we serve the Most High God. One as if you were the Most High God. The Most High God. He was never made. He existed even before. He was there. One as if he were. The earth was just an extension of his majesty. So he lived. Ndio sababu napenda science. Kila siku. Wanasema wameona, tumeona planet ingine. So hizo planet ambazo tunahesabu sile tisa, ni mahali vitu sile tumetengeneza zinaweza kuo. So the more they get knowledge, the more they will see more majesty. Ya Mungu. Ndio sasa, that means 100 years from now, we may have 100 planets. Because now knowledge ya mwanadamu itakuwa imefanya nini, capacity ya kuona itakuwa imeenda juu. Sasa utakuta there are so many planets. So I don't know how we'll call them. Because sasa hapa, we think we have, you know, sometimes whatever is made by the hands of God, by the hands of men, cannot be powerful than the maker. So that means, before you worship an idol, you need to know that you are greater, superior than the idol. Napenda ile ambao walienda kuweka idol yao kwa Mungu ya kwa Mungu, alafu inaanguka asubuhi wanaiamusha. Siku ya pili sasa iliamua kuanguka makichwa na mabini yote ikavujika. Bwana asifiwe. So an idol cannot stand before God. Verse 23 says, he brings the princes to nothing. He makes the judges to the earth useless. Scarcely shall they be planted. Scarcely shall they be sown. Scarcely shall they stalk, take root in earth. When he will also blow on them, and they will wither, and the wind will take them away like stubble. To whom then will you liken me? Huyo ni Mungu anasema, to whom will you liken me? Or to whom shall I be equal, says the Holy One. Lift up your eyes on high, and see who created these things, whom brings out their host by number, He calls them all by name. By the greatness of his might and the strength of his power, not one is missing. God has knowledge for everything. Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel? My way is hidden from the Lord, and my just claim is passed over by my God. Verse 28. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of ends of earth, neither faints nor slumbers. His understanding is unsearchable. One as if you, have you not heard? Then God we praise. Then God we worship is unsearchable. One as if you, he never slumbers. He never sleeps. So even in 2020, our God was not asleep. One as if you, he was not asleep. He always knows. Verses 29, he gives power to the weak. May the Lord give you power this year in Jesus' name. And to those who have no might, he increases strength. May the Lord increase you strength in Jesus' name. I love what God says, that he picks the weak to shame the strong. One as if he were. He picks the foolish things of this world to shame the wise. May the Lord use you to shame the wise in Jesus' name. May the Lord use your weaknesses to shame the strong. You may be weak, but God works in our weaknesses. Have you ever realized? In our weaknesses, God makes us strong. When you think you cannot do it, that's when God is working. By the way, have you ever realized? Anytime you think you are in control, you are not. One as if you were. You are not. Another revelation as I was praying this week, I realized we have no control for anything. Have you ever realized? Man has no control for anything. Even for the cars we drive, we have no control. Have you ever realized that? Unajua saa nyingine unasema, hey, mimi niko smart. Nikiwekelea mguu kwa brakes. Hey, hizo machuma sinaachananga. Wale mmeendesha magari siku mingi, you know what I'm saying. Sometimes you get to yourself, you wonder what happened. Unajipata that car, wale ambao if you have ever been involved in anything on the road, you will agree with me that you have no control of that car. There comes a times when you cannot control the steering, when your legs, instead of stepping on the brakes, you step on the accelerator. One as if you were. So that means man is not in control. God is in control. We need to give God control over everything in our lives. You are not in control of those children. It's God who is in control. You don't know where they go. They just come to you and you think they are very good. You think they are very whatever you think about them. But it's God who takes care. Sometimes we think we have built our houses safely. We are so safe. Tumeweka stima, tumeweka. So we are not in control. Don't think you are in control. Don't think you are in control because you have anything. It's God who controls everything. So I want to remind you this year, you need to surrender everything to God, and they will do that. So, and to those who have no might, he increases his strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fail. But those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. I want us to rise up and pray. I want us to rise up and pray. Just tell God something concerning that word. That this year, you will see the word God working in your life. The majesty of God, the power of God will manifest in your life. In the name of Jesus. I want you to raise your hands and just tell God something concerning your life in 2021. That 2021, God will strengthen your weaknesses. 2021, God will pardon your iniquities. 2021, you will soar with wings like an eagles. 2021, you will stand to claim the word of God. You shall give God control. 2021, of whatever you have, the control over your family, control over your marriage, control over your business, control over everything you do. Dedicate everything to God and tell God to take over. Tell God to take over. Tell God to use you. Tell God to manifest His glory in your life. Tell God to manifest His power in your life. Father, in the name of Jesus, I declare 2021, you shall manifest your power. You shall manifest your glory. You shall manifest your grace in my life. I dedicate my life to you, Jehovah. Father, may you take control over everything. Whatever I have belongs to you. Father, I have no control, but I know all control is in you. All power is in you. All grace is in you. You are gracious, Lord. Father, may you guide me this year. May you guide my ministry. May you guide my health. May you guide my family. Guide my marriage. Guide everything that I do for the glory and the honor of your name. I dedicate all to you, Jesus, and I pray that, Lord, your grace and your glory shall shine in my life. Thank you, Lord, for your goodness. Father, we thank you because we know you shall do it in our lives. You shall do it in our lives. You shall fill us, Lord, with your gracious love. You shall fill us, Jehovah Father, with your power and love. May you, Lord, stand for us. We thank you, Lord, for who you are. We give you glory and honor. We declare, Father, that idols are the works of men. We shall not worship idols, but we shall worship you. Your word shall be final on our lives, because we know the word lives forever, but all things are temporal. Jehovah, I pray this year that I will concentrate on what is internal. I will concentrate on what is permanent and not what is temporal. Father, may you open my eyes to see what is permanent. May you open my eyes to see what is internal, in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless you and exalt you. We give you glory and honor. Father, we declare this year, we shall follow your word. We shall obey your word. We shall live by your word. We shall desire your word. We shall desire your word. We shall desire to serve you. Our commitment in 2021 will be to serve you. We shall not be quiet. We shall speak your goodness. We shall speak your great majesty. We shall speak your power to the men of this world. We thank you, Lord, and bless you, because you are good and your mercies endure forever. In Jesus' name do I pray and believe. In Jesus' name. Let's celebrate God for his goodness and mercy. Thank you, Jesus.